Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to another stupendous Top 13 Countdown, only here on the Friday the 13th Network. This time, it's all about the girls. Let's be honest, Friday the 13th films and slasher films in general are known for their characters
smoking a little dope, having a little premarital sex, and getting slaughtered.
We recently asked you guys what girl had the best rack. You know, the ones that make you go...
Like that, bitch.
Alright, calm down, dude. Before we get started, let's check out the rules for this countdown. One. The actress must have appeared nude or shown her breast in the scene. Sorry, Violet and JJ, who received tons of votes, but I didn't think it was fair to include them over other actresses who did show their breast. Agree? Two. Size does not matter. Character and overall screen time, as well as death, were a deciding factor in the outcome. At least, it seems that way, judging by the votes. And finally... 3. This video is meant to entertain, not offend. It's just for fun. As stated earlier, horror movies and nudity just go together. If you're watching a Friday the 13th film and you don't see a pair of breasts, you're probably watching part 6. 13. Deborah from Jason Goes to Hell starts off our countdown by having sex in a tent at Camp Crystal Lake. It's classic Friday the 13th, and of course, an epic kill. Actually being stabbed through her chest and ripped apart. Would she have lived longer if she didn't throw away the condom? We may never know. 12. Susie and her rack make a small appearance in the opening shots of Jason Takes Manhattan. Her and her boyfriend Jim are on a boat in Crystal Lake, where his hands like to wander from her front to her backside. Too bad they didn't live long enough to make it to the Big Apple. 11. Robin drops the blanket at number 11 in Friday the 13th Part 7, The New Blood. Shortly after, she's thrown from a window. She should have just listened to her friend.
I'm gonna do it.
Robin, you don't smoke.
Instead, she wanders upstairs to her untimely demise. Ugh, poor Robin. 10. Samantha from the final chapter is probably more remembered for her famous skinny dip and raft scene. But she enjoyed skinny dipping so much, she actually did it again earlier in the film with the entire group of kids. Thanks, Samantha. 9. If Robin would have just gave this poor stuttering dude a chance, maybe things would have been different for her. Instead, she retrieves up to her room, undresses, and retires for the night. And wouldn't you know it, right after she shows us her rack, the last thing she sees before her death. 8. Friday the 13th, 2009, didn't have so much nudity in it. I'm sure Chelsea would have placed a lot higher. She had a great death scene, showing off her goods one last time. Maybe it was her annoying boyfriend always wooing that just ruined it. One thing is for sure though, Chelsea can water ski in our lake anytime. 7. Ah, Terry, the first skinny dipper in Friday the 13th films. And oh my, does she go all out, completely undressing and hopping in the lake. And thanks to Scott for stealing her clothes and keeping her nude a little longer. Terry, everyone's favorite skinny dipper, comes in at number 7. 6. We didn't have much time to get to know Lana. She was only on screen enough to show her breast and die. And what screen time she did have, she left quite an impression. While cleaning up after work to meet her boyfriend Billy, she quickly undresses and...
It's showtime!
I have no idea why this scene is even included in the film, but I'm glad it was. Roy then treats her with an axe to the stomach, and we're off to the next victim. 5. Freddy vs. Jason opens with a little Nightmare on Elm Street backstory. We then head on out to Camp Crystal Lake and are greeted by skinny-dipping Heather, waiting for her boyfriend. I bet you guys didn't know that was her name, huh? She then hears a noise, gets scared, and runs right into Jason, eventually resulting in her death, all while her shirt stays conveniently unbuttoned. 4. The virtual campers from Jason X, because 2 is always better than 1, or I guess 4 is better. Now these campers were put here to distract us, distract Jason, and it even worked for a little bit. Until Jason knocked him off with an upgraded sleeping bag death that was awesome, but I really liked the virtual.
3.
Amanda started out the 2009 film with a bang, literally. Like, holy shit, was not expecting this right away. But hey, we'll take it. And so will her boyfriend Richie and his friend Wade from outside the tent. Weird. Amanda comes in at number 3, only losing out to her film's co-star at number 2. Stupendous.
Your tits are stupendous.
Perfect nipple placement.
You got perfect nipple placement, baby.
And juicy.
So juicy, dude.
That all adds up to our number 2 spot, Brie. Everybody loved Brie, and it's so easy to see why. Starring in one of the more visual sex scenes in Friday 13th films, she has quickly became a fan favorite, and definitely Trent's favorite too.
1.
Of course, it's Tina from A New Beginning, played by none other than Deborah Voorhees. And with a last name Voorhees in Iraq like that, she's winning every countdown. If you don't agree, I strongly suggest you go back and rewatch part 5. She received the highest number of votes, over 2 times as many as Brie in our number 2 spot, completely destroying the competition. So everyone, go back, watch Friday 13th, A New Beginning, and check out the lovely Deborah Voorhees, our number 1 rack in Friday the 13th films. And that's another top 13 countdown in the books. Thanks for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe, and let us know your list in the comments below. We'll see you next time for another countdown here on the Friday the 13th Network.